General Atomics Aeronautical Systems Inc, GA-ASI, confirmed on the 23rd of April 2024 that its Mojave Unmanned Aerial Vehicle, UAV, armed with miniguns, destroyed static targets in live fire tests on the 13th of April 2024. GA-ASI collaborated with Dillon Aero to equip the Mojave UAV with two Dillon DAP-6 gun pod systems, each housing a 7.62mm M134 Hybrid Gatling Gun. During the demonstration, the Mojave made 7 passes across 2 flights, firing approximately 10,000 rounds of ammunition and effectively engaging a range of targets. The test took place at Yuma Proving Ground in Arizona and was funded via GA-ASI's internal research and development budget and is a first-of-its-kind live-fire demonstration. GA-ASI President David R. Alexander was quoted as saying in a company press release, "Seeing our Mojave perform this live-fire demo really emphasizes the versatility of the Mojave unmanned aerial system and what it can do. Mojave has the ability to act as a sensor, shooter, and sustainer while mitigating threat environments and vulnerabilities and safeguarding human lives." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Mojave firing DAP-6-based minigun is an interesting development. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Mojave was unveiled in 2021. It's a short takeoff and vertical landing, or STOVL, aircraft capable of operating from very short distances and landing vertically, akin to a helicopter. The manufacturer aimed to eliminate the need for a conventional runway with this advanced drone. Opting for the STOVL design came after determining that a vertical takeoff and landing (VTOL) setup would pose significant challenges. To achieve STOVL, wings are enlarged and have a special high-lift design. It can take off from austere runways as little as 152 meters or 500 feet in length. Also, the landing gear is more reinforced when compared to other UAVs, such as the Predator family. The GA-ASI website says, "It is the next step in UAS evolution, delivering unprecedented expeditionary short takeoff and landing (STOL) performance. C-130 airlift transportability and a significant increase in firepower without compromising any of these significant advantages in endurance, persistence, or aircrew safety over manned aircraft. Simply put, no aircrew is on board in any danger from the enemy." Viewers may note that in November last year, the Mojave took off and landed on the deck of the British carrier HMS Prince of Wales off the United States East Coast in what was called the first-of-its-kind testing, much like the recent live-fire test. Mojave, which is 9 meters long, with a wingspan of 17 meters and a weight of more than 1.5 tons, became the largest unmanned aircraft ever launched from a British carrier. The engine, a Rolls-Royce M250 turboprop, is mounted in a pusher configuration. The drone can be equipped with an array of sensors, such as EOIR, SIGINT, and the Synthetic Aperture Radar Ground Moving Target Indicator, SAR-GMTI, and is capable of land and marine missions. General Atomics has indicated that the Mojave has good flight endurance, though exact details are not clear. Some reports suggest it's about 25-plus hours. A key design feature of the Mojave is its transportability. It can be broken down and transported via a C-130 Hercules or similarly sized aircraft. It can then be ready for a mission in around 1.5 hours with a 4-person team. The Mojave is planned to be controlled using General Atomics' Scalable Command and Control, SC2, system, and likely will be able to operate from already established General Atomics ground stations. Mojave may be equipped with various weaponry, including gun pods similar to the DAP-6. When Mojave was unveiled to the public in 2021, it was seen to feature 7 hardpoints, 4 inboard hardpoints, 2 outboard hardpoints, and 1 center hardpoint. The inboard hardpoints can carry up to 650 pounds or 290 kilograms. The outboard hardpoints can carry up to 350 pounds or 150 kilograms, and the center hardpoint can carry 500 pounds or 230 kilograms. Previous imagery of the drone depicts it outfitted with AGM-179 Joint Air-to-Ground Missiles, JAGM, and AGM-114 Hellfires. GA-ASI has underscored the capability of the unmanned aircraft to carry up to 16 Hellfires concurrently. The maker released the first picture of the Mojave with DAP-6 pods under its wings back in 2022. As per Dillon, the minigun in a DAP-6 pod can fire 3,000 rounds per minute. The DAP-6's maximum magazine capacity is also 3,000 rounds, which gives it 60 seconds of total firing time. 2 of the Mojave's pods could fire at a combined rate of 6,000 rounds per minute during the demonstration. Mojave is an excellent platform. It can be used to fulfill the roles of reconnaissance, close air support, and armed overwatch. Guns provide a distinct advantage in focusing firepower on smaller targets when compared to precision-guided bombs and missiles. They tend to be cheaper and can be faster in shifting from one target to the next. Also, it's a fact that unmanned aerial vehicles are the future. Mojave can be operated by a crew of 2 at the ground station. The recent demonstration coincides with the manufacturer's pitch of the Mojave and the MQ-1C Gray Eagle Hybrid to the U.S. Army, following the closure of the Future Attack Reconnaissance Aircraft (FARA) initiative by the service. So, this is an interesting development. Moreover, there are plans to demonstrate a resupply pod that the drone can carry, enabling it to transport 1,000 pounds or 450 kilograms of supplies up to a distance of 500 kilometers or 310 miles. It'll be fascinating to see how this initiative matures.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.